Welcome back. Today's video deals with one of the important forms of English novel. It is called Bildungsroman in German. In English, it means education novel or a formation novel. A famous example of Bildungsroman is Christoph Weiland's novel Agathon. Goethe also produced his Bildungsroman. Wilhelm Meister's Apprenticeship, which was translated into English by Thomas Carlyle. This video contains all the important information about Bildungsroman, its features, along with some important examples for the students of English literature. I have tried my level best to produce quality material through my videos. If you really like the videos, please like and subscribe Literature Guide so that I can produce more videos like this one for you. As I have told you earlier, that I have produced many videos on English novel, the Gothic novel, the campus novel, epistolary novel, and thesis novel. You can watch all those videos by visiting my channel. I am producing all these videos for the students who are pursuing the NET and SET exams. I don't know whether you find any important information in my videos or not, but if you really like my videos, do like and subscribe Literature Guide so that I can produce many videos like this one for you in future also. Without any delay, let's dive into the video and enjoy the video.
Bildungsroman, education novel. The roots of the Bildungsroman can be found in the writings of Christoph Martin Wieland, K.P. Moritz, and Johann Wolfgang Goethe. The German term Bildungsroman stands for a category of novel which signifies the education or formative period of the protagonist of the novel. It literally means upbringing or education. Broadly speaking, the Bildungsroman deals with the moral, spiritual, intellectual and psychological development of the protagonist. In the course of life, the protagonist of the novel faces many hurdles and challenges in his life, and gains knowledge about one's own self and the surroundings. The experiences mold the character of a hero or heroine. The protagonist searches for his identity, and try to comprehend his role in the society. He also tries to find the answers of his queries. He bravely faces adverse condition in his life. The Bildungsroman covers the time span of hero's life from childhood to adulthood. The experiences of the protagonist teach him a lesson and they also shape his outlook on life. Most of the education novels have been written in subjective tone. Sometimes, the term Bildungsroman is used as an equivalent to both the Kanzlerroman and coming-of-age novel, but there is slight difference between them. The German term Kanzlerroman means artist novel in English, and relates the development artistic consciousness in the artist. The coming-of-age novel relates the protagonist's experiences of late adolescence involving self-knowledge, sexual awakening, choice of vocation and spouse. The earliest example of the Bildungsroman is the history of Agathon of Christoph Martin Wieland. The work deals with the psychological development of the protagonist. The hero goes through many bitter experiences and finally learns the lesson of his life. The novel was published in 1765. Carl Philip Moritz's autobiographical account Anton Reiser also belongs to this category of novel. It was written in four parts and its first part appeared in 1785. Johann Wolfgang Goethe's two novels Wilhelm Meister's Leer Jahre and Wilhelm Meister's Wander Jahre influenced the English novelists to great extent. It is important to note that Thomas Carlyle translated Goethe's Wilhelm Meister's Leer Jahre as Wilhelm Meister's Apprenticeship in 1824. Daniel Defoe's novel, The Fortunes and Misfortunes of the Famous Moll Flanders, can be considered as a novel of education, for Moll learns the lesson of her life through her experiences. Moll is described as an orphan child, brought up by a mayor of Colchester. She undergoes many hardships, marries five times, earns high status through malpractice and settles with her husband in Virginia. The novel follows picaresque tradition. It was published in 1722. It presents the social and economic problems of the period. Henry Fielding's novel, The History of Tom Jones, describes the story of an orphaned boy, Tom, who is found lying on the bed of Mr. Allworthy. In his young age, Tom falls in love with a good-natured girl, Sophia, who is destined to marry Master Bill Phil. The novel ends when all the machinations of Bill Phil are revealed and Tom and Sophia get united. Other major characters of the novel are Lord Fellamar, Lady Bellaston, and Squire Weston. The experiences of Tom and Sophia change their outlook on life. Henry Fielding's novel, The History of Tom Jones, was published in 1749. Jane Austen's famous novel Emma appeared in 1816. It has been considered as education novel for it deals with the formative period of both Emma Woodhouse and her maid, Harriet Smith, an orphaned girl of 17. The novel describes the psychological and moral development of the eponymous heroine, Emma, and Harriet. Charlotte Bronte's famous novel Jane Eyre was published in 1847. The novel describes the experiences of the orphaned girl, Jane, who is brought up by her churlish aunt Mrs. Reed. In the course of her life, Jane goes through many hardships. She studies at Lowood School. She becomes a teacher, a governess of Rochester's ward, Adele. Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre set the platform for Jean Rhys's famous novel Wide Sargasso Sea, which appeared in 1966. It is considered as a prequel to Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre. The novel ends on the union of Jane and Rochester, a Byronic hero. Though the novel was considered unsuitable for young girls, it appeals to the readers. The strength and simplicity of Jane's character appeal to the readers. The novel is in first-person narration. Charles Dickens's novel David Copperfield appeared in 1849. The novel describes a story of a boy, David Copperfield, who suffers a lot after his father's death. He is ill-treated by his mother's second husband, Mr. Murdstone. David is bullied at school by the ruthless headmaster Creakle. In London, David goes through intolerable pain and spends his days in penury. He goes to Aunt Betsy Trotwood, who lives at Dover. But miseries and pain do not let David free. He is ill-treated by Betsy. At the end of the novel, David marries Agnes, a daughter of Mr. Wickfield. The novel describes the relationship of David with other characters and his gradual development as a man. David Copperfield has been considered as the most autobiographical of Charles Dickens's novels. The novel, Mill on a Floss of George Eliot, deals with the life of a brother and his sister, namely Tom and Maggie respectively. The novel presents a contrast between the Tom and Maggie. It describes the social, psychological, and spiritual development of Tom and Maggie. In this novel, George Eliot has artistically portrayed the characters and has given vivid picture of provincial life. Mill on the Floss was published in 1860. Charles Dickens's famous novel, Great Expectations, appeared between 1860 and 1861 in serial form. It deals with the formative period of Philip Pirrip's life. Philip Pirrip is the narrator of the novel, who is called as Pip. He is a village boy who dwells with his bad-tempered sister. At Miss Havisham's house, Pip is introduced to a pretty girl, Estella. Both Pip and Estella undergo a lot of suffering and hardships. Charles Dickens's novel, Great Expectations, comments on psychological and cultural conflicts. Both Pip and Estella learn the lesson of their life. Gustave Flaubert, the French novelist, produced his Bildungsroman, namely, L'Education Sentimentale, Sentimental Education, in 1869. The novel deals with the experiences and changed outlook of the hero Frederick Morrow. The Adventures of Harry Richmond of George Meredith appeared in 1871. It deals with the story of a father and his son. It describes Richmond Roy's attempts to find a perfect match for his son Harry. In the end of the novel, Harry marries an English girl, Janet Ilchester, as his grandfather wished had wished long ago. The novel is highly autobiographical and depicts early days of George Meredith's school days. Mark Twain's famous novel The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn is a novel of formation. It appeared in 1884. It deals with the life of the protagonist Huck Finn, who is a narrator of the story. The novel comments on the absurdities and hypocrisies of society. The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn is a sequel to The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. The novel depicts Huck Finn's development in the passage of time. The novel Kim of Rudyard Kipling appeared in 1901. It presents the account of Kimball O'Hara's life. It describes Kimball's experiences in Lahore and travel with a Lama in Tibet. Kimball worked for a secret service under the supervision of Hari Babu. The novel also comments on the diversity in India and the life of the bazaars. Samuel Butler's novel, The Way of All Flesh, was anonymously published in 1903. The story is narrated by Overton. The novel deals with the life of Ernest Pontifex. It comments on the Victorian view of family life and satirizes the evils of ecclesiastical upbringing. In the novel The Way of All Flesh, the protagonist, Ernest Pontifex, inherits wealth of his aunt Althea, which enables him to study literature. He experiences complete freedom from the institution of the family. George Bernard Shaw appreciated the novel. D.H. Lawrence's famous autobiographical novel Sons and Lovers appeared in 1913. It deals with the relationship of the protagonist, Paul Morel, with his mother, Gertrude, Miriam Levers, and Clara Dawes. Paul's early childhood experiences, his relationship with a romantic girl, Miriam, and his love affair with Clara change the outlook of the protagonist. The novel is set in the coal mines of Nottinghamshire and it has working class background. A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man of James Joyce can be deemed as an education novel as well as an artist novel. It deals with the experiences of the protagonist, Stephen Dedalus, from his early childhood to his adulthood. The novel describes Stephen's loss of faith, his sense of guilt due to sexual adventures as a young man. The character of Stephen Dedalus also appears in James Joyce's famous work Ulysses. A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man of James Joyce was published between 1914 and 1915. Of Human Bondage of Somerset Maugham comments on the experiences of a lonely child Philip Carey and his relationship with Mildred, a prostitute. It is important to note that Somerset Maugham borrowed the title of the novel from Spinoza's work Ethics. At the end of the novel, Carey marries Sally. Of Human Bondage appeared in 1915. Thomas Mann, a German novelist, produced his Bildungsroman, namely, Der Zauberberg, The Magic Mountain, in 1924. The novel describes the events of the life of an orphaned child, Hans Castorp. After the death of his parents, Hans Castorp is brought up by his grandfather and his maternal uncle James T. Knapple. The novel has a background of the First World War. In the end, Hans Castorp serves as a volunteer in the military. Rosamund Lehmann's novel, Dusty Answer deals with a girl's enlightenment and her womanhood. The protagonist of the novel is Judith Earle. The novel describes Judith's childhood and her upbringing and her intimate relationship with Jennifer. The novel shook the literary arena with its modernity. Rosamund Lehman's novel, Dusty Answer, was published in 1927. Doris Lessing's five-volume novel, Children of Violence, was published in 1952. It presents the story of Martha Quest from her childhood in Rhodesia and her life in Britain.
How is the video? I hope you liked the video. I will meet you soon with a new video with an interesting topic in a few days. If you really like the videos, do like and subscribe Literature Guide and visit my channel to watch all the videos on the English novel which I have already produced. I will meet you soon with a new video. Meet you.
Please subscribe Literature Guide.